We are in conversation with Professor Satinder Dhiman from Woodbury University, California, USA. Once again, welcome, Professor Sir. You have given us the roadmap, and it's a wonderful beginning on the 1st of January 2020, while wishing from both of us a very happy new year to our audience and to the entire universe on this particular day. We are moving ahead in the first part of this particular program. He discussed with us what are the mega trends in higher education globally, the world over. What are the mega trends? Thank you very much, sir. They were very, very enriching.
My privilege.
And they were very, very knowledgeable, and it gave me a lot of insight. Now I wish to share with you that Ministry of HRD, Government of India, in their new education policy and what all is coming through, this one subject which is given a lot of emphasis is called moral education. Moral education, ethics and all that, when we talk about, would you be kind to emphasize this point a little more, relating it to India's old civilization, historical perspective, and our epics and our Vedas and whatsoever you can take related to that, how the moral education is very important for today's younger generation in our education system.
Yes, I'm so glad to hear that the Ministry of HRD has undertaken this August operation to introduce the understanding, or at least to garner the understanding about moral education. I think moral education is very vital. You might recall that during the last 15 years, world over, many big corporations have failed. They have failed not because their leaders were not up and up with finance and strategy. They failed because of some kind of moral ineptitude, that there was some sort of moral lapse on the part of the leader. So I'm very glad that the Indian government has undertaken to ensure that our youth are trained in ethics. Now, what is ethics? What is morality? Morality is about what is right, what is wrong. And we need that every step of our life. You mentioned about Indian epics and Indian scriptures. One of my favorite scripture is Bhagavad Gita. And as you know, I have done some translation as well as my recent book on Bhagavad Gita.
You have done a lot of work on that.
It has been my life work, so to speak.
Okay.
Spirituality in the workplace, and Bhagavad Gita is the centerpiece of that work. The very beginning of Bhagavad Gita, two words, dharma kshetra, kurukshetra. So if you just take those two words and
dharma kshetra, kurukshetra.
Yeah. So if you rearrange them, that means kshetre kshetre dharmam kuru, which means kshetre kshetre meaning every sphere. In every sphere of life, dharmam kuru, do what is right. Now the word dharma is very beautiful. It doesn't mean religion. You know, sometimes people translate dharma as religion. That's a very narrow, literal translation. Dharma means what is the true nature of a thing. For example, the dharma of fire is to burn. The dharma of water is to be wet. Similarly, what is our dharma? That is what Bhagavad Gita is all about. So the very first word is dharma. Kshetre, kuru, kshetre. Dharma kshetre meaning it is the sphere of right action. Kuru kshetre meaning it is the karma bhumi, kuru bhumi, where you have to do karma. So how to do the karma which is within the domain of dharma, that is what Bhagavad Gita is all about. Now the very first word of Bhagavad Gita is dharma. The very last word is mama. Mama. Mati mama. When Sanjay says, when the Gita is finished, Sanjay says, whichever side Lord Krishna is, whichever side Arjuna is, that side is Vijay Bhuti. That side, there will always be victory. And Mati Mama. So if you take the last word Mama, the first word is Dharma. Mama Dharma, my duty. That's what Gita is. So the entire Gita is between these two words. What is my duty? So the moral education that we want to. And then Gita elaborates on many things. I would like to emphasize only one thing for now, which is, one of the things which Gita talks about is doing good to others. It is called sarva bhuta hite rata. There is two times when this particular thing comes in Bhagavad Gita. Lord Krishna tells Arjuna that if you really want to achieve what is called moksha, like in this life, it is called Jivan Mukti. If you want to live like a Jivan Mukta, then you have to develop this quality. And what's that quality? Sarva Bhuta Hite Rata. You should be immersed in the well-being of others. So if you have that heart, and then Lord Krishna says, I think it comes twice, once in chapter, I think it comes in chapter 5, Shloka 25th, and chapter 12, Shloka 4, Te prapnuvanti mamev sarbhuta hite rata. Those people also attain me, they also attain me, they only attain me who are immersed in the well-being of all beings. So if we can take this message, if we can ask before we do any action, how is it going to benefit others? How it's going to add to the common good? How it is going to add to the well-being of the entire society? Not just mine, but others. I think that will be a great thing. And then Bhagavad Gita gives a guarantee. It says that people who do this, nothing wrong will happen to them. So Lord Krishna says, Nahi kalyankrit kaschit durgatim tat gacchati. To those who do good to others, they never see misadventure. They're unki durgati kabhi nahi hoti. Those who are devoted to the kalyana of others, to the well-being, welfare of others, durgatim na kaschit, unki kabhi durgati nahi hoti. And there is another chapai in Ramayana, as you mentioned about epics and you mentioned about other things. In Ramayana, Tulsidas ji says, Parahit bas jin ke man mahi, jin logon ke dil mein dusron ka hit bas jata hai. Parahit bas jin ke man mahi, tin ko jag durlab kachu nahi. Unke liye kuch bhi mushkil nahi. To agar aapke dil mein dusron ka hit karna hai, dusron ki achhai basi hui hai, to fir Bhagwan bhi aapki madad karte hain, aapke liye kuch मुश्किल नहीं है. फिर आपको दुनिया याद करेगी. हातम की तरह लोग हमें याद करेंगे. एक शख्स हुआ है, उसका नाम था हातम ताई. He used to do good to others. तो एक शेर याद आ रहा है, दो लाइनें अर्ज करूंगा आपके लिए कि हातम की तरह लोग हमें याद करेंगे, रखते हैं बुरा पास भला बांट रहे हैं. तो ये है अंदाज उन लोगों का, अपने पास बुराई रख के दूसरों को. और यही संतों की खूबसूरती है. रामायण में शिव जी पार्वती उमा को कहते हैं, उमा संत की यही बड़ाई, कि जो संत है उसकी यही बड़पन है. उमा पार्वती संत की यही बड़ाई, मंद करत सो करत भलाई. जो उसके साथ बुरा करता है उसके साथ भी अच्छा करता है. जैसे चंदन है, आप चंदन को चाहे ऐसी जगह रखें बदबू जहां से आती है, चंदन बुराई नहीं हासिल करेगा मगर उसको खुशबू
दे देगा.
हालांकि जो लकड़ी चंदन को काटती है, वो लोहे की जो काटने वाली आरी है, उस आरी के को भी वो खुशबू दे देता है. जो चीज आपको काट रही है उसको भी आप खुशबू दे दो. ऐसा है कि आपके आपसे अच्छा हो. हमारे स्क्रिप्चर्स हमें ये बताते हैं, जिंदगी का मकसद, पर्पज ऑफ लाइफ इज नॉट टू बी रिच or to amass money. The purpose of life is to develop your gifts and use them for the good of others.
Wonderful. Such a illustrative, you know, magnification you have given of the moral education, which is very important for Indian education system, and particularly in the new education policy, it is coming in a big way. We will take some more inputs from you in the next episode on that from you. Thank you very much. Let's remain with us. We will be coming with the next part of this particular conversation. We are in conversation with Professor Satinder Dhiman from the Woodbury University of California, USA. Thank you, Professor.